zone, institutional academic overview, research and tech transfer. That's going to be my focus, and I'll try to be pretty quick. And if you have a burning question along the way, please let us all know. Otherwise, we'll go to the end and we'll have questions or so then. Tim, the next one. So our campus is part of a four-campus system. Sometimes we pretend it to be two, in that the Anschutz Medical Campus is really part of the University of Colorado Denver downtown. But for practical purposes, there are four different campuses, a mini system of the University of California system, but they're really closely located. Colorado Springs, about an hour and a half away. Now we take pride in the fact that we are the flagship institution in the state of Colorado. We're also a national comprehensive research university. So we have all sorts of pretensions and ambitions to do great things in research and tech transfer. Next one. A little overview on the academics. We're nearly 30,000 students, a little bit over 5,000 grad students. Large number of students of color. We have had a challenge in attracting and retaining students of color, but right now things look quite stable. We have about 800 student veterans with different needs. Many of them are graduate students. 1,750 international students from 85 countries. Can you see this from way back there? Okay, good. So we have a large number of students also studying abroad in a large number of different countries. We are about 7,200 employees, 1,100 or so tenure-track faculty, 400 instructional faculty, instructors, senior instructors, and the like. 1,720 research faculty who ultimately report to me. That's of course why I'm having them here. They're research professors down to research associates. We also have 780 postdocs on our campus, which is a large number, who really strengthen the research mission. About 3,900 staff and officers, including research staff, professional research assistants. Next one, please. So we have 9 schools and colleges, fairly compact compared to many universities in the California system. Our Arts and Science College has nearly 22,000 students. Most of the faculty are there. Law School, where we are, is one of the smaller schools. We offer 3,600 courses in 154 fields of study, which is very similar to the UC system. Some campuses would nearly have twice that number of fields of study. We offer 78 BA/BS programs, a large number of different master's programs, including Masters of Fine Arts, etc. Law Masters at the very end. The curious thing, we have a Law Masters following the Juris Doctor, but never mind the sequence of things. 55-50 programs. Some of them are the designations in speech, learning, and hearing languages, so forth. We granted 6,900 degrees in the last academic year, including summer. We also take great pride in a large number of residential colleges in enrolling 44% of all our incoming freshmen. We have found that to be an excellent way of retaining freshmen in designated areas. From engineering to sustainability to economics, business, and the like. It's like a mini college you can put on your loafers, go down to class, and really pretend you're someplace in a fine institution in the UK. Next one. So, some bragging rights. And Francis, you remind me if I'm...
Okay.
So, we have been a member of AAU since 1966. Although we know that many institutions in the University of California system go back to the previous century beginning.
The other folks may not know what AAU is.
American Association of Universities, an elected, esteemed, fine, exalted status for public and private universities. it's sometimes very unclear how you get elected into it, but that's usually what secret society is. So, George, what do you think on that? That's fine. So we have 5 Nobel Prize recipients. Our pride and joy. 7 MacArthur Fellows, 68 faculty members are members of the National Academies. We have 20 doctoral programs as part of the 20 top NRC categories. In fact, we have 10 in the top 10, which is pretty darn good for a university that does not really receive much state funding. More about that later. 5 National Medal of Science recipients, bundle of AAAS fellows, 10 Packard fellows, 4 Presidential Early Career Awards just last year. So we have about 3 or 4 per year, which is tells us that the quality of our junior faculty is pretty darn good. Bunch of Guggenheim fellows and Fulbright fellows, going back to the early days of the Fulbright category. Next one. So our budget on this campus, about 1.3 billion. General fund, including tuition, makes up 600 million. So we receive a little bit more than 50 million from the state of Colorado. But 15 million of that is designated as need-based scholarships. Goes essentially directly to the students. So about 35, 36 million come to us for operations and so on. Auxiliaries, dorms, dining services and the like, 300 million. And research, about 400 million. We're on track for about 410 this year. So here's the more awkward part of this. State funding per resident, full-time equivalent. So 12 years ago, it was $8,633. Similar to what you see in the UC system. The past couple of years, $62 per credit hour. So if a student takes 14, 15 hours per semester, double that in a year, you know, about $1,800 is what the state gives us per headcount undergraduate students. Grad students, separate fee for service, with funding per graduate student resident is actually lower than the undergraduate funding. A little awkward, but we have learned to live with it. Next one. In terms of research, we have 11 fairly large research institutes, ranging from the Cooperative Institute for Research in Environmental Sciences, with nearly 700 employees, down to the smaller Institute for Cognitive Sciences, with about 70 people. Faculty belonging to academic departments often have their homes in these areas, especially engineering, natural sciences, some social sciences. We have 92 centers in humanities, music, but mainly all the way across to engineering, some business, and natural sciences. So it's a rich academic milieu. Some of them are affiliated with institutes. And these centers range in size from 200 faculty members down to 2 or 3. So we do have a rich variety. Now, what really helps us here, and on this day you can't quite see it, but across the way are a bunch of local federal research labs. Bureau of Reclamation is closer to Denver, but the National Institute for Standards and Technology is right across the way, and we collaborate in all engineering disciplines, physics, chemistry, biology, and like. Very important to us, and our students have research opportunities, mentoring opportunities in these labs. The National Renewable Energy Lab, going all the way down. Now, dare say, if it hadn't been for the proximity of these labs, we would have a hard time dealing with support of graduate students and postdocs. Next one. Why do we do research? Reminding ourselves. And George, that's probably one of the reasons you guys do the same. Creating new knowledge, discovery, proving, disproving hypothesis, all these noble things. Universities are really good at basic fundamental research and applied to some extent. We are increasingly becoming used to doing more translational tech transfer finding out what's really of benefit to society. So we've had a tech transfer office on our campus for nearly 30 years. The last 20 years, it's really taken off. And you'll hear more later from Kate Tolman.